One of the things I love about Godot is just how easy it is to support different languages. Let's make a simple scene with a button. I'm setting the text of the button to be the key we'll use for localization. Godot will automatically map this key to text in different languages, so let's make a spreadsheet for that mapping. The first column will be the key, followed by any language codes that we need. I prefer to save this spreadsheet in something like an Excel format, so it's easy to add colors and notes. But ultimately, we'll need to save a copy as CSV in the UTF-8 format. Godot will automatically import this and generate translation files. Note that if you want to use a CSV file for something other than translations, you can change that in the import settings. Now, it's almost as simple as that, but you'll notice the button still isn't translated. We need to go to the Project Settings Localization tab and add the translation files that were generated. For the most part, it's that easy. But sometimes you need to dynamically set the text of something. So I'll create an example script that will set this label when our button is pressed. We simply need to call the tr function to translate the text. Then we update our CSV file with the translations. Godot uses your OS language by default, but if you want to test different languages, you can use the translation server set locale function. Here's Spanish. For more advanced dynamic text, you can use format strings. These allow for dynamic words to be placed in the correct order for various languages. For example, some languages have the adjectives before the nouns, and others have the adjectives after the noun. Now we can call format on our translated string and pass in a dictionary of mappings to translated values. Of course, you probably procedurally generate this dictionary, but this is just a quick example. And here it is in English as well. If you want to localize assets like images and sounds, you can easily do that as well. In the Localization tab of the project settings, there's an option for remaps. Add whatever resource you want to be remapped, select it, then add your remaps. Click on the language under the locale and you'll see that there are a lot of options. Click on the list and start typing to find languages faster. Now if we switch our locale back to ES for Spanish, we can see the image was swapped out. If you're using custom fonts, you might run into issues with missing characters or characters falling back to the default font, especially with Asian languages. To fix this, go to the import settings of the font and under fallbacks, add the fonts containing the missing characters to the array, then re-import. I should also mention Godot supports standard GetTextPO files, if that's what you're familiar with. You can quickly generate a PO template by going to the Project Settings, Localization, POT Generation, adding any scenes and GDScript files that need localization, then clicking Generate POT. There are tools designed for working with these files, but it seems you can just save the POT file as a PO file, specify the language in the first message string, throw some values in, and add this PO file to the Translation tab in the Project Settings. Looks like you can mix and match with other translation files as well. There's a polyglot spreadsheet with a CC0 license that's been floating around with lots of common game words and phrases if you need a jumpstart on your translations. I'll link it in the description. If you set up your own spreadsheet to match the language columns like I did with Fist of the Forgotten, it makes it really easy to copy-paste whole rows. Note that the language codes that Godot uses contain an underscore between the language and country, so be sure to check the documentation for how to set up the specific language that you want. Another great resource is the Microsoft Terminology Search, which helps you find the right word or phrase depending on context within an application. I'll link these resources in the video description, and I can't really think of much more to add, so here are the awesome patrons who support me sharing my game development knowledge. I really appreciate it. If you find these videos helpful, maybe consider joining them.